January 2012. Venue, Togome School Grounds. Mr. Chairman, the Paramount Chief of Togome Traditional Area, Togbe Asamoah Kwanta Disease, Honorable Deputy Minister of Information, invited guests, the Circuit Supervisor, the Fadidome Circuit, the Headmaster, Togome DAJHS, the Headmistress of Togome EP Primary School, members of staff, elders of Togome community, parents, ladies and gentlemen, it is our greatest honor to have you in our midst. Indeed, this is the first time in the history of Togome community to have a city minister like you paying visit to us. Really, history has been made. Honorable Deputy Minister of Information, we have seen the good works you are doing for our country, Ghana. We believe and trust that you will do more for this newly created district and for that matter, Togome community, if elected as our Member of Parliament. As an institution like this, there are so many things it needs to enable its objectives to be achieved. These needs are computers and computer laboratory, teachers, tables and chairs, pupils desks, school jersey and footballs, renovation of the school blocks and teachers bungalow. It is our hope and prayer that you are elected as our Member of Parliament so that you will move the constituency to the level expected. May God continue to bless your effort. Thank you.
Distinguished invited guests, and head teacher, and everybody, honorable minister. I am sorry that I'm not going to be able to speak ever out. I'm loved to. So, pardon? Great. I am happy to be here with you this morning with our friend and brother Sami. I recall when I was at the Ministry of Information, his passion, particularly about this constituency. Anytime we needed to strategize and to talk about situations, he would always would say that he wants to do something for particularly this area. And that's a passion that continues to drive him. And that is what gives me satisfaction that at least today, through his instrumentality, we've been able to bring these number of computers to students around here. I'm sure that anybody who has followed him will know that he's a young man who takes his work seriously, who took and still takes his education seriously, and he's consumed by that passion to see that these little ones we see here will also have the opportunity to develop, to enhance their capacity. And in this day and age, ICT is everything. And if you come to think of it, that students are studying about computers and they have never seen computers before, or they've never had an opportunity to touch it before, then I think that Sami was right in his zeal to get these computers for these young brothers and sisters who are here. My simple, small advice though, will be that we release it to the student, to the pupils, to be used for the purpose for which it is intended. Again, I think that in this last couple of years that it is, all of you attest to our young brother and friend Sami and what he's been able to do for Mother Ghana. It will be arrogant on my part to tell you what to do or to choose for you who should lead you. But I believe that, I mean, in these last few years, given the fact that he's relatively young on the political stage and the kind of impact that he's making, not just here but across our entire nation, you can see things for yourself and on the basis of that decide whether you want him or you want some other person to provide leadership for this area and to help our young ones with opportunities like this. This is only the beginning, and I'm sure that he would want to do some more if you give him the opportunity and to place him in the proper place that will give him the chance to use his influence and instrumentality to help lift this place and to quicken the pace of development. Thank you very much.
From a wing, and our lovely looking young brothers and sisters, I want to welcome all of you this morning. Today we are here for a happy occasion. We are here to receive 24 laptop computers. I have been coming here. We have been having our meetings in some of the classrooms with the delegates and all of that. And I noticed that the whole school, there is no computer. You don't have a computer lab. Yet still, when it's time for the BEC exams, you are going to write ICT, you are going to write computer examinations, and you are going to be competing with students from other parts of the country who have many computers, who have computer labs, who have computer teachers. That is not a fair opportunity that you should be going through. It is important that we bring up the quality of education. It is important that all our school children everywhere at least have a fair opportunity to compete equally so that you can pass your BEC exams and you can progress and become meaningful citizens to your society, to our nation, and to your families. That is why we are here today. These computers are part of President Mills' vision to make sure that our basic schools receive computers. For too many years, schools across the country are not receiving the needed practical ICT attention. You cannot be learning computers without knowing how a computer looks like. You cannot be learning about the mouse without knowing what the mouse is, about laptops without knowing what a laptop is. You can't be learning about click. Meanwhile, you don't know how to click. You don't know what click is. You can't be learning about Word, about Excel, about PowerPoint, and you don't know what all these things are. When you have only done theory on paper, it's chew and pour. So it is very, very likely that you fail the exams because you don't have the practical experience, especially if the questions are very practical questions and you need to relate how you would do it if given the opportunity. So it is our hope that these computers will go a long way to enhance the study of ICT. We are also appealing to the headmaster and the teachers that they should please take good care of them. As you know, computers are very fragile. If they drop, it can get spoiled. You need to also check the temperature. It should not be too cold or too hot. You need to always keep it in very good temperature. You need to make sure you keep it in a room that the windows will not be open, and when it rains, it will go into the laptops and destroy the motherboard, and that will be it. So we will appeal to you to take very good care of it. This is just the beginning, and we are hoping that the next time we come here, we'll even be looking at constructing a modern computer laboratory so that the children will learn. We also would want to appeal to other interested groups like the PTA, like Togbeo and Mamau, to also take interest in managing the whole computer and ICT education. They should encourage the children to learn, if it is even possible, to have extra classes for not only students at Togoma, but other young people in the community who also want to have ICT education. Please avail that opportunity so that there are many, 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 many advantages if you learn computers. In the modern world today, when you learn computers, even software alone, there are many, many things you can do, many jobs that you can get. If you learn hardware too, there are many, many, many jobs that you can prepare yourself for. Then there's networking, there are other aspects of this whole ICT education that can also create new jobs, new job opportunities for the youth and for our children. So the possibilities when you have computers are enormous, and we would encourage you all to take advantage of the possibilities. We would also encourage you to try and connect them to the internet. These days it is not very, very expensive, and we would be available to assist you if you need any further assistance on how to connect to the internet, so that it can enhance the children's learning even doing research about checking their mails, and even getting in touch with other students across the country and across the world, so that you can compare notes and share ideas and all of that. So this is the beginning of many more possibilities that is under the Better Ghana agenda. When Professor Mills promised a Better Ghana agenda, this is what he was talking about. And as you know, Professor Mills cannot do it alone. Professor Mills cannot visit all the schools in Ghana. There are thousands and thousands of schools. That is why he has appointees who must make sure that they bring good report and tell the president that there are areas or there are schools that also need attention. And that is what I have done. And when I told the president, about Togoma LA, he was very, very excited that there is a school here like that, and there are people who are willing, there are teachers, there are headmasters, PTA chairmen, and the students who are also willing to be part of the Better Ghana agenda. So we are here to present them. We want you to take very good care of them, and we want you to continue to encourage the students to study hard. The students too listening to me, make sure that you study very hard. You draw a timetable and you follow the timetable. You don't need to rush and then cause commotion and destroy them. They are very fragile. When is your time for studies? I'm sure the teachers will tell you, and all of you will have the opportunity.